Hello everyone, today let us see how to get the latest data of a particular device or devices. So here is the landing page that we get into in the Zabbix, and then to get the latest data, in the left pane under the monitoring tab we click on the latest data. Here I have already put up a server name which I want to get the latest data off. As we can see, for this device I have already deployed certain OS related templates, because of which I am able to see the matrix being populated with the latest data. We can see in the leftmost part the server name, the next one being all the matrix like the CPU, the disk, the processes, the network components, memory components, services, etc. After that, the last check. This is basically going to tell us when was the last time the data was being pulled against each of the metrics. The last value tells us what was the previous value it could fetch from previous polling. This will tell us almost the latest update about that particular metrics that has been collected on a particular device. Here the change will tell us the difference between the last poll and the before last poll. So to understand this a little more, let us get on to this. For example, CPU utilization, we can see that it is 0.025% used, and a negative percentage in the change, which means that compared to the previous poll, the data has reduced in its consumption compared to the before last poll or the last poll. Going a little further down, CPU utilization, it says that it is 49%. The total is a 30 GB drive and the use space is around 14.73 GB. And it says it has 48 processes total and the number of threads being 627, which is reduced by 25. This is the server name, which is in the system description. This is the local time of the server, and this is the system name, and these are some of the network related components. And we can also see that a lot of memory related components has been picked up by the default templates. Of course, we can change or modify the templates as per our requirement, but if we deploy the out of the box template, we're gonna get the data for all these matrix. So here we can see for the memory utilization, around 70.5% is being utilized. A total of 1 GB RAM is there. Total swap space of 630 MB is there. And a used memory of 721 MB is present on this device. Here it tells us the host name of the device and the version of the Zabbix agent running, which is almost the latest, and whether the Zabbix agent is able to ping or not. With this template, we can also see a lot of services also being monitored for its running state. And here we can see that the bits service is in a stop state, which we will also see in the alerts pane or in the dashboard. We also see the CDP SVC service is also in stop state, and the DNS cache is also in stop state. I intentionally stopped these services to show how the services will be reported down when there is an issue. The last part being the Zabbix agent availability, which tells that the Zabbix is available, and the most important, last but not the least, being the uptime of the device, which says how long the device has been up and running. So this particular device has been up for more than a day and almost 7 hours. So this is the summarization of the latest data for any device. If needed, we can put more than one device and collect more information about more than one device. But if we have more metrics, then it will become more inconvenient to visualize the data. Here, as we can see, I have put two servers, but the first one is displayed with all the information, and after it collects the information of all the metrics for the first server, then you start getting the information on the second server. We can see that for the Zabbix server, the CPU utilization are captured, and then we are seeing the disk related information, file system related information, general information, network related information, memory related information, security related information, system status information, Zabbix raw items information, and Zabbix server related information. So a lot of data will be captured when the default template is deployed, and it is not a recommended practice to deploy the default template as is. We should understand what is more important to us and capture only those metrics, and we should trim down the unwanted templates. It is a good practice to clone a particular template and retain only those metrics that are really necessary for us. And another recommendation is that we should not deploy with the default polling interval. It could be 1 minute or 5 minutes. We should change as per our requirement and deploy on this server or the servers accordingly. Also, we should make sure that we should not be deploying the default severity, like the high, disaster, warning, average, just as is. As per our requirement, we should make the changes on them as well. Let's see more of the videos in the next one.